Which data should we consider first? Now, as we are trying to identify first what are the different user requirements, and then we are going for the same. Then, if we are scaling our project into the data warehouse, and shall we able to manage it in future if it is scaling? Scaling means if it is going to increase more in number, more than in sizes, more than as a data sizes. Definitely, can we manage it, and how to do that? If we get such kind of answer, definitely it will help to design a better data warehouse. Now, if we are scaling, the current infrastructure which we are providing, is it enough? Can it incorporate all those scaled projects into the data warehouse? So that thing also we have to consider. So these are the questions which we need to understand. Sometimes what happens for many enterprises, to avoid the complexities with design, the data warehouse is started by building one or more data marts. So normally it happens that to avoid the complexities associated regarding designing of data warehouse, many enterprise start data marts rather than directly go and design complexities in the inside the data warehouse. So that happens sometime. So that enterprise data marts, we know the data warehouse which is specifically application oriented related to any single enterprise is called as a data mart. So many enterprises, what they do, they want data warehouse, but as they understand the designing complexities, rather than directly going to solving those, they start building one or more data marts regarding that enterprises. And this is how they start for developing a data warehouse. These things also we have to consider most. That's why we said which data should we consider first. Accordingly, our data warehouse design will start, our methodology will start. So that's why we have to consider these things also. Just let me check. Anybody's in waiting room? Okay. I think currently nobody's there. Okay. Next, data marts allow designers. Now, why data marts? For many, because that is the option which many enterprises are going. The data marts allows designers to build something that is very simpler, and which as a designer they can achieve for a specific group of users. And that's why data marts are first designed. Or can we build a data mart for any specific enterprise? That is the one idea which is checked. And if yes, automatically, which will help building data mart, which will help designer to build a better warehouse, data warehouse, and they can achieve for a specific group of users the effective implementation of the same. Few designers are willing to commit to enterprise-wide design, which must meet all user requirements at a one time. So rather than going more step by step, some designers, what they think, rather than again doing modifications and again thinking one aspect, then taking into consideration, this will also create some chaos. And to avoid, some designers, what they think that we will understand all the requirements at a one time, and at one time we'll try to give a solution. We'll try to design enterprise-wide design which will meet all user requirements at a single time. Definitely we can do that. Yes, we can do that. So that is where we are considering the methodology, design methodology, data warehouse implementation methodology, which is better. So whichever idea we gives us the better implementation, better effectiveness of designing a data warehouse, that is chosen. Now we are thinking that data mart we are building, but that is not the final solution. Final solution is to build or to develop a better data warehouse.
Just we are thinking rather than directly going, we can have a small part and then we'll understand what are the different problems, what are the needs, what are the things which we need to do, and we can implement it. So the goal is
remains
same. The ultimate creation of data warehouse,
which will support
all the requirements of the enterprise, along with the all the
users of the enterprise, right?
so goal will be the same.
How it is implemented? So it is implemented by collecting requirements. So requirement analysis,
Requirement
gathering and analysis, that we would
we
say a life cycle step, software
development similarly
clearly.
data warehouse development. So we
Collect all the requirements of all the users and analyze it.
each stage
Of that data warehouse, wherever we feel, and we can have appropriate members of staff, for example, marketing users, finance users, sales users, all these we can consider, and we enable them to identify and priority.
prioritize set of requirements. So marketing users requirement, and what is the priority
For him,
finance user requirement, what is the priority for him sales user requirements, and what is the priority for sales users. So all these things will be prioritized.
and we can think that
The data warehouse will meet all these requirements. So this is how the design
of
of
data warehouse will be done.
So at the end, my data warehouse will fulfill all the requirements of all the users. And for that, we need to analyze and collect the requirements of users.
At the same time, what else we can do? We can have interviews with the members of staff
who are working as marketing users, who are working as a finance users, sales users.
So we can have interview
of these members or staffs responsible for operational systems, and then we can identify which data sources
are required. Which are the data sources which we can provide them,
which will have a
clean
it means correct
data, valid data, consistent data, and which will be
remain supported for not only
single
and
day,
not only for months, weeks, for next few
years.
so if as a
University data,
university as an enterprise,
if we consider university people
require the admitted student of previous years also, the PRN numbers, their mark sheets, it's all these things. So the data should be supported not only for 1 or 2 years, many years, and such a way we can have our
data warehouse, and to provide some time as definitely we are going to collect user requirements, but we will also have interactions with them. We can have interactions with them and we can identify what they require. Yes, just a minute. हाँ सर, Okay, we'll continue. So there we are, that we'll understand the user requirements, we'll have interviews with them, we can have a chat with them, we can have a discussion with them, so that we can ask, identify definitely those people who are working really, who will be in need of data, right? So we'll identify which data sources they required and which data sources we can provide them valid, clean and consistent data, which will be not only for a small time, for a longer time of period they can access it. So such a way we'll try to design data warehouse. Now what these interviews or discussions, chat with the people who are operating will give us, they will provide the necessary information for the top down view. Right, they are the final users, no? They are going to use, access it. So that's why we can have a top-down view, user requirements, and bottom view, which will be available, so that we can build, we can have an idea that which data sources are required, which are available, and which need to make available. And again, keeping those clean data, valid data, and consistent data. So we can have that view. And we can describe the component, database component of data warehouse using a technique, and that is called as a dimensionality modeling. So that's why we say there are two types of modelings, right? So out of it, one is a dimensionality modeling. So there we are. So there are two main methodologies which incorporate the development of enterprise data warehouse, EDW, which we say. And these are proposed by two key players. One is by Kimball's Business Dimensional Lifecycle, that is Kimball 2008 model. And one is Inmon Corporate Information Factory Methodology, that is CIF, Inmon 2001. So these are the two methodologies available to incorporate development of EDW, that is Enterprise Data Warehouse. Now, Ralph Kimball is a key player in data warehouse. He is supposed to be the key player in the data warehouse because he has developed dimensional lifecycle, one model. He has created a kind of infrastructure which will be having capability to support all the information of an enterprise. So as an example, we have seen university, right? So to provide university all the required information, the infrastructure is needed. And Ralph Kimball is a key player who has given such kind of infrastructure we can build, which will have a capability to support all the information requirement of the enterprises. We can use new methods and techniques so that we can develop an EDW, enterprise-wise data warehouse. So Ralph Kimball plays a vital role here. Kimball starts by identifying the information requirement. As I said, he starts by identifying the information requirement which we can analyze. So which is referred for analytical themes for analysis purpose and associated business processes of the enterprise. So we can identify what are the business processes implemented by enterprises. So we can have identification of what data sources they require. As I said, so university, what they implement as a process. So that is a business process I'm attaching to the example university as an enterprise, right? For example, Solapur University, if we consider. So their process is that identify which are failure and appearing, current year appearing students list. And they need to fill the forms and for a particular time being. And after the time slot is over, they can identify how many of filled forms and they can allocate them the exam seat numbers, right? So this is the process. So this is how they implement a process. So as a model, we need to understand that so that we can provide that how many students have filled form, exam forms, right? So this is how we need to do that. And Kimball business lifecycle, dimensional lifecycle model methodology starts identify this kind of information of enterprise. So this will give us, so this activity results in the creation of critical document, which is called as a data warehouse bus matrix. So once we do this process, that identify the information requirement which is associated with business processes of that enterprise and give this for analysis process, this activity will give us one document, and that document is called as data warehouse bus matrix. Hope you understand data warehouse bus matrix means what. It is a document which is the result of collection of information requirement from enterprise, and also this information reflect the associated business processes of that enterprise. Now, main guiding principle here is to meet the information requirements of that enterprise by building a single, integrated, very easy to implement, high performance information infrastructure. So the infrastructure of that enterprise will be in that position that it can be integrated. It is very easy to use, and which will provide information. High performance means 100% information available. So goal is to deliver the entire solution, including data warehouse, ad hoc query tools, reporting applications, advanced analytics, and all the necessary training and support for the users. So this is what is the goal. Providing, developing a data warehouse means what? What for it is required? To provide a data, provide whatever simple queries are there, the answers for those queries. Handling all these query tools, efficiently providing data. If we need to generate reports for different applications, we can do that. For advanced analytics, right? So this is what is the goal. I think our time is up. We'll stop here. We'll just understood what is required to do to develop a better data warehouse. And we have a clear picture regarding one model which focuses on information gathering and analysis. Also, it focuses on discussion with those people, those users who are actually operational. It means they are implementing, they are using. So identify their problems, identify their needs, and such a way provide such data warehouse which will fulfill that. So I think that's it from my side. If any queries are there, you can ask. Okay, remaining part will continue in next lecture. Probably we'll try to finish as early as possible so that you can get a time for preparation. Okay. If no queries are there, then we'll stop here. Thank you for joining. Wish you a good day. You can leave, no problem.